Hello and welcome back again to another video on Kdenlive. In this video, we're going to look at how to create this drop-in text right inside Kdenlive. So before we move on, we just want to let you know that we know many of you have been watching our videos but did not subscribe. If you can subscribe to our videos, it will be a big great help so that we can continue to upload more videos. Now let's get back to business, seeing how we can create this drop-in text animation. So right inside the project bin, do a right click and add your title clip. Now we just need to type in what we want to do. So since it's a drop-in text, we need to type in, and we can change to a thick font, and we just change the font to 100. Now let's create this. Let's create another text again, and this one animation, and then let's create this, and let's create the final text, and I'd like to change this back to a thin font. Now let's change the color of this font to something apart from what we have now. So let's change this to blue and then create that. Now let's bring all our text down to one on track one, and we need to insert two more track here. So let's right click here and insert the track. Okay, so let's move this to video track two, and then our next to be up here, and then the final one to be at the top there. Okay, so now let's align this text nicely. So let's go to the first one, and let's just click this one, placing it here, and then update this. Go to the second one and then align it nicely like that, and then update this, and then the final one something like that, and then update it. Okay, so this is how our text is gonna look like, though it is not in the center, but it's okay. And now let's do a rubber selection of all this one and move a little bit like that, and bring in one of our video clip and paste it right underneath here. Okay, so let's just trim in this text in like that, move in some frame up to you, and then move it in like this, and then we can do the same for the other side here. Okay, all good for that. And now let's apply the effect to the text clip. So let's go to the effects panel here, and in the template here you can see there's already zoom transition in and zoom transition out. So if you want to use this one, it's okay. I just want to show you how we can get the same thing. So let's go to the effects and the transform, distort and perspective, and let's apply the transform to the first clip here. Now once we do that, you can see we have this now. So let's place the playhead right in the start of this text here, and then in the size here we want to increase this to 500. Okay, so now let's place our playhead somewhere here, almost to touching this other clip here, the second text clip there, and then add a keyframe and change the value of size back to 100. So this is how it's gonna look like. Okay, so now the next one, we're going to do the same thing, apply the transform and then change the value of size to 500, and this time since it's on this side, it's big, so we want to move from the X value to the right. So let's just try to hide this text, okay, until it's hidden that way. And then move the playhead close to the last text up there, add a keyframe and change the value back to 100, and then from the X value drag back our text in again. Okay, so this is how it's gonna look like. So you can see it zoom in and comes to stop there, and now let's do the final one. So let's apply the transform again to it, change the value of size to 500. Since it's coming down this way, we go to Y and go to the move to the positive side to hide this text, and then move the playhead somewhere there, add a keyframe, and then change the value of size back to 100, and from the white move this up here. Okay, so this is how it's gonna look like now. Okay, we can do the same for the end here, but it's the same principle again apply to that. So if you know that, you can also do that. So follow this one. So this time we just do the first example there, place the playhead here, add a keyframe, go to the end, add another keyframe, change this to 500, and then from the Y value hide that again. Okay, and then let's go to the next one, add a keyframe, move to the end, add another keyframe, change the value to 500, and then from the X moving to the right to hide the text. And now let's go for the final one, selecting it, add a keyframe, move to the end, add another keyframe, change the value of the size to 500, and that's it. And here is the final result for this. Since we did not change the keyframe interpolation to linear, that is why you can see it's kind of looks steady there on the screen. So we need to do that by selecting each of this clip, change all of these to linear. Okay, so we are done changing everything to linear, so this is how it's gonna look like now. Okay, the final thing is to create this blur effect on our text. So to do that, we're gonna use the blur effect. So let's go here and type in blur. And you can see you have different blur here, but what we want is use the square blur. So apply this square blur to the first text there. So you can see already there, it's kind of blurred already because we applied the blur effect. So let's minimize the transform. And you can see it comes in. And then from here, let's add a keyframe. And then move this something like that. And when it's trying to touch or go in like that, add another keyframe and bring this down. Let's do the same for this other text. Apply the square blur here, coming in here, add a keyframe, move this little bit back in like that, and once it's about to touch this other clip here, add another keyframe and change this all the way like that. And let's do the same for the final text, bring it in here, add a keyframe, bring the canal size down, and then once it's go in like that, add a keyframe and bring this down all the way. So this is how it's gonna look like. Okay, so that's how we create this nice drop-in text. And thank you for watching, and if you have not subscribed, you can do that. It would be a big great to us, and see you back again in another video.